Okay, so here we are at Twin Lakes on the back side of Megan. As usual, the road up to the Horseshoe Lake? I'm forgetting the name of the lake now. The name of the lake with all the dead trees is closed, so we're going to have to rough it there. This may not have been the easiest path to take, but it might be one of the more fun paths. Charming little lodgepole pine wood here. I seem to have found a path going the right way. Okay, well that path turned the other way, but wait, maybe this is it coming back here again. Well, anyway, I'm pretty sure my destination is this way. I think once we go over this next rise, we'll see Horseshoe Lake looming distance. Or into the near foreground? I'm not quite sure. Well, there are a bunch of dead trees here, which are probably related to the CO2 from the volcano. I don't see a lake. Maybe I'm not in exactly the right place yet. I guess they're cutting down the trees now. Don't want them to fall down on people. Well, here you go. A victim of the volcano. So just to back up a little bit. The mountain up there is Mammoth Mountain, which is an active volcano, at least geologically active. One of the ways we know it's geologically active is because it's outgassing carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is coming up with magma out of the mantle. But as that magma cools down in the upper crust, it bubbles out all its CO2. And then that CO2 rises up to the surface. In the soil, it can reach very high concentrations that are high enough to, for example, kill trees. Also, apparently it's dangerous here in the summer, sorry, in the winter when there's snow, because CO2 can get trapped under the snow. And then, if skiers fall through the snow and get their head trapped under the snow, then they suffocate. It shouldn't be too harmful right now in the summer, though. Still some few patches of snow here and there in the shade. And it's June 7th or something like that? Maybe 8th or 9th? I don't know, it's early June, let's put it at that. Well, with the road closed, there's not a lot of crowds here. A little bit eerie coming along the vacant parking lot. Like, normally the road is closed because when there's snow, they don't want people up here. So people don't get trapped under the snow and asphyxiate. Although when I was there earlier, it looked like they were just doing tree trimming. Although maybe they just did tree work. Maybe that includes all this clearing up of these trees, actually. Now that I think about it. It's actually quite barren over here now. All these snags. There's Horseshoe Lake down there. Water looks a little low. Carbon dioxide hazard area. This area is subject to elevated levels of naturally occurring carbon dioxide, CO2, colorless, odorless gas. This gas, which is leaching up through the soil, has been known to accumulate in snow depressions or low areas. Exposure to high levels of CO2 can be fatal within a very short period of time. The best prevention for overexposure to carbon dioxide is to stay out of the posted hazard areas. Well, I think we'll just stay out of any depressions in the ground and we'll probably be okay. We have a little bit of a breeze today. Yeah, I think these bathrooms have been closed for a while because of the hazard of CO2 accumulating in the bathrooms. So once again, all the dead trees here are caused by the outgassing of carbon dioxide from Mammoth Mountain volcano. So that's it right there, actually, is the volcano. And so several kilometers underground, there are intrusions coming, have basalt coming up out of the mantle, and as those cool down, the CO2 bubbles out and comes up through the crust, and the levels in the soil can be high enough to kill trees and people for that matter. So I'll try not to stick my head in any holes in the soil. And there's Horseshoe Lake, looking pretty good. Whee! Good patch of snow! I'll just try not to stick my head in it. Fun stuff.